Okay.
Sebastian came out with a new skit.
Oh, he did? Oh, I got to go check it out. Netflix. His new, well, yeah, his, that's his whole thing, minus a few things that he did on the tour. But that's the new tour.
Yeah.
Bro, I can't wait to see it again. My jaw was hurting. Fucking hilarious. All right, so guys, the day has come. I don't think I've ever anticipated a car more than this particular car. It's actually an SUV. The Rolls Royce Cullinan just pulled up outside. We're going to give you a first look at it coming off the truck. Now, I know I said I was hyped up about the Urus, and I was, and I still am. I love that damn truck. But this is it. This is a whole nother animal, a whole nother level of car, and it's outside waiting for us. So let's go out there and take a look at this bad boy. Let's go. A lot of movement. It's a Saturday. Very busy. Got a few cars left. You need somebody to open it? Yeah, somebody open for you now. All right. All good?
What's good?
All good, my brother. What'd you end up taking?
The trap.
The Don?
Yeah, the Don.
They hooked you up, right?
Yeah, who are you?
Matt, bro.
Oh, what the fuck? I'm talking to him, Matt, the whole time.
No, they try to pretend to be me, copy people. That's why I got the cameras following, so
you
know the.
Yes,
Philly. My Philly people right here.
All
right, enjoy yourself, okay?
Yeah.
All right, brother. Woo! Rolls Royce is everywhere. Get this man out here. Just do this thing. Oh, he is? Okay. All right. Okay, bye. What's up, brother? How are you?
Not bad. How about you?
What do we got? Elite Auto Transport. Okay. He brought us our baby. Let's have a look. Beautiful trailer. First look. Oh God.
Damn.
God, that's pretty. You're not ready for that. I know. Next time you come though. All right, bro. It's good. What? I think it's available, yeah. That's good. That's a good one. Wow, look at that grill. Jesus. Let's give people a little teaser on the IG here. Gotta get it right. My boomerang's gotta be right. All right, no more. Did the Cullinan come in yet? It's here, it's officially here. First look, boom. You ready for your first starring role?
I got my
Okay. Chris and I are gonna be doing a little skit for the, of course, the first sight of this thing on our Instagram. And we got something a little creative for you guys. If you haven't seen the movie Paid in Full, I suggest you watch it. If not, stop following us.
Hey, you feeling this joint, baby? This that new shit, man. Meek ain't even got this. I mean, the Kardashians ain't even got this. You feeling me, man?
You motherfucking spaceship, man. You got the red guts and shit.
Let me take you for a spin, man. Show you what it feel like.
Gonna make you drop off, B.
Yo, you think you're the only one out here working, B? I gotta make drop-offs too, B. I ain't taking no for an answer, man.
So to get some dead presidents, I need money. I used to be a stick-up kid, so I think of all the devious things I did.
One, two, three,
I used to roll up. This is a hole-up. Ain't nothing funny. Stop smiling. You still don't nothing move but the money. But now I...
Hold on. Put that down for a second.
Yo, Matt, where you at? Bro, I needed that car to W an hour ago.
Take the car back right now. 5 minutes. I told you I gotta make drop offs too, B.
Very classic.
Very. It's Ace Boogie right here. Bite. I said that's a truck.
Truck.
That's a whip. Alright. Wow.
That shit dumb.
I don't know nothing, but I'm about to find out. Golly. Go ahead and move it up a little bit more. Huh? Nothing like a Bentayga. You think so? That's fine. Of course, the boys had to put the McLaren. I don't even know how to open this one. Where's the unlock? I already see some options.
Right, we gotta get these mats out of here before people destroy them.
Yeah? Get some mats. Regular. Yeah. All right. This thing is, this is very serious. Absolutely sick. Check out the keys. Huh? Leather wrap backs. Amazing. Of course, you guys know that we're obviously in business with Metroline Auto Group, and now they also have McLaren up there. So, big things. This will buy you a nice house. It's a house on wheels. A very nice house on wheels. Jesus. A monstrosity of a car, to say the least. Oh, look at that. Now it goes away much faster. That's an upgrade. Good afternoon, MVP Exotics. Okay, sure. For when? All right, no problem. What are you looking for, a double R? Let me tell you how it feels. Feels like you're moving an entire living room smoothly through the streets. That's how it feels. It's incredible. It smells amazing in here. Yes, sir. All good, bro. So, Ted says you need a car for a video shoot or something. All right, guys. So, I don't have a ton of information, and most of the time, you know, I really talk about the stuff that I like about the car rather than the specs or whatever cool technology packages it has. I can tell you right now, on this car, I know nothing other than that it's beautiful. Of course, we got the big old sunroof. They're not gonna do the, we gotta give this guy some money because we look very rich in this car. So if we don't give this guy some money, it just wouldn't be right. Let's shoot him 10. I always hook up the homeless, and not just when we're recording. Here you go, my man. And he's a veteran. It's very nice. Never seen it before, right? I know, it's the only one.
I'm pretty sure your mind is just as big as mine right now.
Mind blown. Show them the back there. We got Salvatore. That's the big boss poppy right now, okay? I don't know what you guys heard, but that's who he is. Got a cooler back there. Bunch of other stuff. We can't even get the back to function right now. We might even have to stop at the dealer.
Start blowing you up like that.
By doing skids?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, this one goes. And I think maybe we'll stand out by doing skits that are like, cool, got some humor, but we're not trying too hard to do like stupid shit.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, okay, well, you know, this guy's not just being an idiot.
Yeah.
Even though some of these guys that have done stupid shit have done well for themselves, and that's good for them. But you know what I'm saying, right? Like a lot of the influencers are really just, oh, okay, do something stupid, and all of a sudden you're an influencer. So if we do like more culture-based skits where people are like, oh shit, you know, we're gonna do this paid in full one. Obviously, the people that have seen it are gonna catch on and be like, "Oh shit, that was dope, that was creative,"
yeah.
And then some of the other people are gonna be like, "Yo, what's paid in full?"
Yep.
And those guys that have been under a rock, they can come out of that rock and watch it and be like, "Oh shit, I never knew about this movie." So when we first started, kind of thing, when we first started, I would never think we'd be buying a $500,000 SUV. I'll tell you that much. But yeah, when we first started, when I first started, I was buying $30,000 cars. So we've come a long way from that. And also, I remember seeing everybody else with like, I just finished sharing with you guys that my first car was the Lamborghini Gallardo. And I remember when I had the Gallardos, the Huracans were out, and everybody had like the bigger companies had the Huracans. And I was like, oh man, maybe one day, you know, or the Aventador. Golly, when that Aventador came out, I was like, man, I hope one day I'm at that level. And not only being able to buy it and put it in your fleet, but actually being able to move it and have the clientele that rents those kind of cars. But we're there. We're there, man.
What do you think was one of the biggest things that got you to this point throughout the 5 years of starting this business?
Well, to be honest with you, it's been 5 years, just a couple days ago, since we opened, but it's really been 2 years since we started to stand out and really blow up. So what's happened in the last 2 years has been unreal. It's been unreal. Once I left that warehouse that I was sharing space with the other two companies and came into that showroom by myself, I think we just started to stand out more. and people just started to be like, wow, you know, I'd rather go there. That place looks cooler. Those people, you know, I didn't want to just create a company where it's like, yeah, we got the cars, rent it, get the money, and it's done. I was really focused on building relationships with our clients, you know, becoming friends with our clients, you know, getting to know our clients, and now reaching our clients on the social media platforms like we're doing now. And I think that's what made us stand out from everybody else. You know, like everybody else, of course, the other companies got their Instagram pages and they'll post pictures of their inventory. But obviously you can see we're doing more than that. And, you know, going the extra mile and connecting with our clients, I think that's what has made us stand out and take it to the next level. And then, of course, dealing with the celebrities, the hip-hop artists, the big names in the game, I think that gives us a lot of credibility. And people are like, oh, okay, well, if that's where this person goes, that's definitely where I should be going to get my cars.